Hey guys, it's Video Hits. Festina here, coming to you from the HQ this morning with Amy Meredith. Hello.
Hello, how you doing?
Hi, I'm very well, Christian. Good. How are you?
Very, very good.
Costa, how are you?
Very well, how are you?
Excellent.
Now we've got that sorted.
Yes, let's move on. Earlier, I spoke to you guys for the Australia Day concert. Yeah. Actually, Costa, you went there.
No, it was just
I was there playing,
but yeah, it was me and Joel.
Yes, hanging out in the House of Reps.
Exactly.
And now we're here, and now you have an album.
Finally,
out. It's out now.
I know, how exciting! We've been waiting for this for a while. So.
Is that why it's called Restless?
It's exactly what why it's called Restless. We kind of it sums up the experience that we've had as being in a band. You know, want things to keep happening and always setting these new goals and. I guess we're just anxious and really want it to hurry up and get out there. So it's great that it's happening.
Yay! Cool. All right, so you started out with 60 tracks back in the day.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, that's kind of what happens when, I guess, you're in a band and you go through all these different stages and all these different styles of music. You know, one minute this style, and then the next kind of week you're playing a bit of a different style. So you get to pick from all these different genres, and it's kind of bit of a fitting journey from where we've been, like, you know, 3 and a bit years ago to now where we're at.
Yeah.
So I guess it's kind of...
I think it's an amazing how the songs that are on the album have come together, though, out of, you know, that many songs to get into this little collection. They're so vast, and I don't know, I think it works.
Yeah, there's definitely
nicely together.
A variety of different songs, like diversity on the album because of that, because it's taken, you know, 4 years to put together.
That's right.
You get to kind of pick from all these pieces and have one song that was the first song you ever wrote, and one song was the last song you wrote before walking to the studio.
Which one was the first song you ever wrote?
Black Eyes, and it's the start of the album.
Yeah, I dig it.
And the last song on the album, which is called Start All Over Again, and that's the last song we wrote. So, like, we didn't pick that, but it kind of was the first song on the album is the first song, and the last song is the last song.
It's meant to be that way.
Yes.
12 excellent songs. 12 excellent songs.
You have
found
it.
I found
good.
The love. Closer is a great track. Yeah. I really dig that track.
That's an oldie as well. That's one of the first ones we kind of ever wrote. Again, I know we're kind of channeling early influences of like Morrissey or something like that at that point. Just the kind of rhythm of his lyrics and kind of that kind of style. Yeah.
What other bands influenced you on this 4 year experience?
Everyone's got such different influences. Like Costa, you're into a lot of...
I listen to a lot of different music. You know, stuff I've been listening to lately is like Steely Dan and a lot, you know, Miles Davis Quintet and lots of different stuff.
Yeah.
So we're all from such different places. The boys are from more of a...
Well, they listened to like punk when they were younger, like, I don't know, like NoFX and like Brand New and all these bands. And I listened to like a lot of Britpop, like Pulp or like... Oasis and the Beatles and the Cure, and it like grew up listening to Roy Orbison and Jeff Buckley and all these different people, and I don't know, everyone kind of fuses these different influences to kind of get a contemporary but yet kind of
it almost subtle. Seems like it wouldn't work, but somehow we all come together. I don't know, it works.
Luckily enough.
It does. And a great team behind it. Rob Connolly, of course. Yeah. He's worked with some amazing people, including Outkast.
Yeah.
I think, is it Aerosmith?
Well, no. Brian Paderewski worked with Outkast and Aerosmith.
Ah, damn.
But no, we had like a co-producer kind of thing on it. So like Rob has worked with a lot of people. Rob's worked with Ricky Martin, actually.
Ricky Martin.
You don't have to tell anyone that. No,
which
he's worked
one?
With a lot of...
Uno, dos, tres.
This is before he came out, actually.
Or before he came out.
Yeah.
Well, he was famous before he came out.
Yeah, exactly. So there
anyways, but yeah.
But Brian's worked with Outkast and Aerosmith and I think Silverchair as well and a lot of different artists.
Okay.
But we got Mark Needham to mix the album. I don't know. Like, he's worked with... The Killers, he did Hot Fast, he mixed that record, and Hot Heat, and Fleetwood Mac, which is another favourite of ours. So he kind of took it to another level, really.
It's a dream team, really.
Really is a dream team, kind of combining everyone and their strengths. Yeah. We handpicked Mark because we were obsessed with Hot Fast at the time, you know. So.
That's cool. Yeah. That's cool that you got what you wanted.
Indeed.
Now, the single, Lying, I love the music video.
Yeah, it kind of was a bit painful having such beautiful women all over us. I don't know how we coped, actually.
It was a lot of fun to make. Hard work, though. I was playing the drums for quite a few hours there, as hard as I could, so I almost fainted at one point. But
really?
Other than that...
It's hard work making a music video.
Girl, actually.
Well,
fainted. It's a bit ridiculous.
It was close. We had to actually keep taking my shirt off and blow drying it because it was covered in sweat, literally.
Yeah, no,
and it looked ridiculous. You know, one take I'm dry, one I'm... wet, so.
But you just wanted to show your body to the girls, really, that's kind of what was happening.
Well, it was my idea.
He actually had pegs put on his nipples by the girls in the video, so right. It's completely normal. It's just another day
in the
world.
Did it feel good?
It felt quite good, I'd say.
Why did I ask that? You got feathered though. You had it all right.
I know. I was the one that got feathered, so to speak. With girls straddling and holding me back, I was fighting against. You know, it was against my will, of course, as you can see in the video.
It was like you were fighting hard.
I was fighting so hard. I didn't want them to hold. I didn't want them to hold me. You know, I was a bit. I was upset. But,
the tack pins were the worst. I'm sorry.
Yeah, he actually. I don't know if you've seen the behind the scenes footage of that video. He's Cam actually got very injured in his foot, and there's a massive cut, and he was bleeding for a while because it was legitimate tacks.
What?
I don't know what we were thinking. We
were
meant
what
to take
were
the,
you thinking?
We were meant to take the ends off them, but they thought it'd be more realistic to get his kind of anguish.
And so Cam's crazy.
Injured.
Why did he draw the shortest straw or something? What happened?
No,
there?
Was just they were just like, we need the bald guy because they didn't know him at the time. We need the bald guy who looks a bit like a thumb to get tacked. Obviously, because look at the thumb. Thumb tack. There you go.
That's the way it just happened.
It just happened
okay.
That way.
Are you into Japanese game shows? Is that where the inspiration came from? Do you watch it on YouTube or something? Or
no, I don't. I don't know about you. Do you?
Well, I shouldn't say what I look up, but sometimes.
Costa's a bit. Yeah, he's a bit random with what he looks up.
I
but,
won't be touching your MacBook anytime soon, dude.
No, Japanese game shows are quite funny. They don't make any sense to me. So I guess that's kind of why, no disrespect to the game shows, obviously, because, you know, that's. But, like, I guess that's kind of why we went with that whole
that
flow. Like, let's just go with something that, you know, doesn't make sense. We're
it's fun, yeah.
It's a good video. I love it.
Thanks,
I
man.
Dig it. Will there be more?
More
fun videos or
I
more serious ones? What's the next single?
The next single is called Young at Heart.
Oh, yeah.
And
it's
kind of a bit more serious in a sense, but I guess it's sentiment of it is kind of youthful and fun as well. But we always want to have a little bit of fun in our videos, even if we touch on some heart at the end of it.
Mm.
Like Modern Family, you know that new show on TV? Has anyone seen that new show?
No.
Well, it's kind of heaps funny.
It's on Channel 10, is it?
Yeah. Oh.
Oops. I'm in trouble.
Maybe I shouldn't talk about that. It's all good.
This is our network. That's fine.
Oh, well, there you go.
Modern
Family.
Watch every weeknight or whatever it's on.
It's like really funny.
Tuesday night on 10.
There you go. Well, it's kind of funny, but at the end they always have these like real meaty heart moments. So
okay.
That's kind of what we're about.
I'm sold. Yeah. You've sold me to watch a show on my own network.
You should probably
that hires me. Excellent. That's cool. Tour. Let's talk touring.
Yeah.
Will you be hitting the road anytime soon?
We are. We actually just came off the road. We've been touring since the end of February,
mm-hmm.
and we kind of only just finished. We toured with Cobra Starship, Our City, Evermore,
Stereophonics,
which was incredible, and did our own little tour.
Our own headline tour.
But
was nice.
Which was good. It was interesting going from playing to like 3,000 people to like playing to our own 200 that we'd stolen from all these little areas, I guess. But
it feels good.
Yeah, because it's your own 200 people.
It was our own 200.
I might be exaggerating.
But now that the album's out, it's the album tour, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, we're going to be doing an album tour end of September or beginning of October,
okay.
I'm thinking. But we're hitting the road with Grinspoon as well.
Hey,
we love
fun.
Those guys. I owned Guide to Better Living when I was in year 7, I think, year 8.
Does it freak them out when you say stuff like that to them?
No, we haven't met them yet.
Oh, okay.
But, we will
Bill
be.
Will freak, I think.
I know, but I think he will freak. But maybe we should
He'll
cover
feel old, that's for sure.
Dead Cat times 3 or whatever it is, because I don't play that live anymore, so maybe we should cover
just
that.
Just the fact that you say, dude, I got your record when I was like 12 years old.
I know. I think I'll avoid saying that, maybe.
A little bit
maybe.
Embarrassing. Yeah, we've got to work out a particular way. Cobra Starship, though.
Yeah.
Hilarious dudes.
Rad fun. Mm. A lot of fun. It was really good to get on the road with kind of a band that's, I guess, similar in their mentality of, like, not partying, but, like, enjoying each other's company and kind of, after the show, hanging out, inviting us into their room, coming back to our room and hanging out. We don't have a room. kind of just hanging
Feeling
out.
With your rider.
Exactly. No, Gabe, they're such down-to-earth dudes.
Gabe's
and Gabe's, like, he kind of gets it. One thing, like, he kind of said was, you know, we were just going into his room, he was offering us food and drinks. I'm like, why do you offer us stuff? Like, it's all good, man, we're fine with our one beer to share between 5 people. He's like, no, I just remember what it was like to be the support band and getting nothing. So
yes.
It was kind of a bit humbling, I guess.
He is cool. A really genuine bloke. I think.
He's a cool dude.
Everyone in the band was actually. Yeah. They were great to us. Yeah. They treated us with respect, which was nice.
And Adam from Our City kind of just introduced us to like his laptop, and it was kind of cool. We just chilled out a little bit. Yeah,
oh, that's nice. Different energies.
Yeah, it was good. He's a nice guy as well. The whole Our City guys were cool as well.
Yeah, we
just
can.
Not as much of a party band.
Yeah, yeah. All right. Anywhere else on your sights? Do you plan to go overseas or anything?
Definitely looking at going overseas very, very soon. I think end of July we're looking at doing a bunch of showcases over there because there's a little bit of interest and kind of just taking it up. Who knows with these things? We're just kind of taking it as it comes, but
that's
I guess
right.
We're all working hard towards
that's
that kind
cool.
of the next adventure, you know?
Yeah. Well, all the best to you guys.
Thank you.
This is Amy Meredith, everybody. Peace.
Thanks, man.
Peace and love. Woo. Yeah.
You too.
Here we go. Amy Meredith coming at ya. Video hits.